Since you're here, you probably already know that Scratch is an easy-to-learn and use graphical programming environment from MIT. It is also the easiest and most fun way to introduce your kids to programming. We'll start this series of tutorials on Scratch by introducing you to the Scratch programming environment and to the terms that are used to describe it. First of all, the Scratch development environment has four distinct areas. Please follow the cursor as we visit them. First, there is the canvas area where all the action takes place. It is called the stage. Different backgrounds may be placed on the stage to change the setting. The characters or actors on this stage are called sprites. Each sprite can help multiple instances or looks, and each of these is known as a custom. Another area of the screen is used to select the stage or the sprite to work on and for loading or creating new sprites. The selected sprite or the stage is displayed in perhaps the most important area of the screen, the one where a set of instructions, programs, or scripts, as they are termed in Scratch, are assembled to control each of these active elements. This is also the area where additional sounds get imported or recorded for use with the current active element, and where additional sprite customs and stage backgrounds are painted, imported, or photographed. What makes Scratch different from most programming environments is that it has a very limited set of commands, all of which are easily accessible through a straightforward, visual, and intuitive drag-and-drop interface. These instructions are grouped by type into 8 areas, with different commands applicable and available for operating on the stage and on the sprites. First, motion grouping has all the motion-related commands like move, turn, point, and bounce off the edge. The second area is looks, and it's a grouping which includes commands that change stage backgrounds, sprite costumes, and colors, and display text uttered or thought by the sprites. The third area is sound. These are commands that produce sounds, as well as control the volume of these sounds and their tempo. Pen group allows sprites to draw as they move and to control thickness and color of the resulting lines. Control commands are used to start, stop, test a condition, or perform and repeat an action. Sensing commands allow for interaction with the user by checking for key presses or mouse action and its location. Operators tab is set aside for all the arithmetic, comparison, logical, and string operators. Finally, there is the variables, and this is where variables and lists are defined. This concludes our first introductory lesson on Scratch. In the next tutorial in the Scratch tutorial series, we'll show you how to build your first Scratch program. If you like this Scratch tutorial, please give us a thumbs up, add it to your favorites, subscribe to this channel, and come back here for additional tutorials on Scratch and other subjects.